Right. Okay. In this video, I shall be discussing what makes a relationship a healthy one. What makes a relationship healthy? Recall that previously we've been discussing how to make your relationship a healthy one and how to avoid a boring relationship. Now, if you have or want a romantic relationship, you probably want a healthy one, right? But what's a healthy relationship? What does it mean exactly? Remember that a healthy relationship depends. It depends on the persons involved. It depends on the personalities involved. A healthy relationship doesn't actually look the same for everyone, since people have different needs. What you need in a relationship might not be what I need in a relationship. Your specific need around communication, sex, affection, space, share hobbies or values or some may change throughout life. So a relationship that works in the 20th century may not be the same in the 21st or 22nd or 30th or even 50th century. So relationship don't align with more traditional definition of a relationship. That your relationship, you want your relationship to be healthy enough, doesn't actually mean that it must be a monogamy sort of marriage or polygamy sort of marriage or polyandry. No. This depends on the personalities involved. In fact, healthy relationship in broad terms depends on the need of the people in it. It actually depends on the need of the people in it. However, how does it look like? A healthy relationship, what it looks like. Now, one thing healthy relationship largely share is adaptability. Adaptability. A healthy relationship tries to adapt to circumstances, and then the fact that there is always changes. Remember, change is always constant in life. So throughout the different phases of life, recall that your man might not be so strong as when you met him, or your woman might not be so energetic now as when you met her, but changes occur. So these are the things you have to notice in a relationship and be able to adapt to it. It is only when you have adapted to these circumstances and facts, these changes, that is when you notice truly a healthy relationship. However, these are the facts that you need to know in a healthy relationship. One, open communication. We've discussed largely on the issue of communication. If you communicate openly and freely to your partner, you are building a healthy relationship. But if you do not, that relationship may sometime, somehow, crumble, because there is no healthy relationship that exists between the two partners involved. And that is why communication is paramount in every relationship. Second one is trust. Trust involves honesty and integrity. So you don't keep secrets from each other. When you are apart, you don't worry about them pursuing other people. So always trust your partner. And then this trust has to do with honesty. So you tell your partner the truth so that your partner will trust you. Some persons will continue to lie in their relationship. For how long shall you continue to lie in your relationship? What if your partner gets to know that you have lied to her or you have lied to him tomorrow? The trust you think you've built through lies may crumble immediately. That is why trust has to do with honesty and integrity. If your partner gets to know you with A, maintain that A. And if there is anything that will make you to deviate from that A, let your partner know. Let your partner know. So that tomorrow, you may not feel insecure in your relationship. Remember, trust brings security in a relationship. You can go back to our previous video and listen to trust, what we discussed on trust. A sense of self as a separate person. Healthy relationships are best described as interdependent. Interdependent means you rely on each other for mutual support, but still maintain your identity as a unique individual. In other words, your relationship is balanced. You know you have the approval and love, but your self-esteem doesn't depend on them. There are some persons that, I'm married to him or I'm married to her, so all my responsibilities, everything about me now depend on him or now depend on her. No. A sense of self-dependence. You don't just have to carry your load and then give to your man or give to your woman. That relationship may not be healthy. Sometimes this your woman that you are giving your whole burden may find it very difficult to meet up with your load. And then the relationship becomes boring and unhealthy. So you should find a way to maintain an interdependent in a relationship. Curiosity. Curiosity is one of the major characteristics of a healthy long-term relationship. Curiosity. This means you are interested in their thoughts, goals, and daily life. You want to know. You want to watch them grow in their best self. You are not fixed on who they used to be or who you think they should be. So you are always flexible. You know, maybe your wife was doing this or doing that, but you want her to do more. Now, you're always giving her, baby, my love, my wife, do this and do this one. That is being curious. You don't want to remain stagnant at a particular place. And that is why, because a relationship whereby both partners have same mindset and stays together and shares ideas together, they want each other to grow. They want to grow. And that is why they always share ideas. This is how to do it best, and this is how not to do it best. And then when these things happen, you see both partners growing. And that is why you need to always share your ups and downs with your partner or with your boyfriend or with your girlfriend. It makes a relationship healthy one. Time apart. Most people in healthy relationship prioritize spending time together. Like we said, spend an awful time together with your partner. Playful and light-heartedness. It's important to make time for fun and spontaneity when the mood is right. If you can joke and laugh together, that's a good sign. You see, a relationship whereby both partners always quarrel, argue, nag, and this and that, that relationship is not healthy. So you should make out time to play, have fun with your partner. That's what makes a relationship a healthy one. Physical intimacy. We've discussed intimacy extensively. You can go to our YouTube channel and watch about physical intimacy. It doesn't really mean sex. It doesn't always mean sex. But not everyone wants sex. So you should make your relationship a healthy one. It is not sex that makes relationship a healthy one. You should try hug your partner, kiss your partner, cuddling, sleep together. That's what makes a relationship a healthy one. You see, married couple, after some month, you see them sleeping in different room or different bed. It is not proper. It does not make the relationship a healthy one. If you both enjoy sex, your physical relationship is most likely healthy. When you feel comfortable initiating and talking about sex, too. When you can positively handle rejection, when your wife said no, I don't want, or your man said I don't want, handle it. When both of you can discuss desires, And then when both of you feel safe expressing your interest in more or less sex. So healthy relationship also involves respecting sexual boundaries. This includes not pressurizing partners about sex or specific acts when they say no. Sharing information about other partners and then discussing sexual risk factors. This makes your relationship a healthy one. Next one is teamwork. If you don't work together with your partner, that relationship is not healthy. Your partner do not know your whereabouts, and then you do not know the whereabouts of your partner. How will you make that relationship a healthy one? So a teamwork makes a relationship a healthy one. So that means you have each other's back at every point in time. Next one is conflict resolution. How are you able to handle conflict in your relationship? It matters a lot. It matters a lot. So learn to handle conflict in a relationship, because when you handle your conflict, because conflict is bound to happen in every relationship, but the way you handle the conflict in the relationship, that's what matters most. So handle your conflict the way that tomorrow you won't flash back and say, oh, I didn't do this thing very well. And that is why every now and then you need to think before you talk. You need to think before you act. And please don't forget to like, comment, and share. Thank you very much.